What's up, everybody? Lance Cassidy here, and it is time for another episode of Let's Play Super Mario RPG. So, we have just defeated Mac and collected a star piece, and according to our new friend Mallow, it is time to head towards Tadpole Pond and hopefully learn more about what these stars could be about. So, let's get right into things and have the plumber do some actual plumbing. Before this video begins, though, I do have to give some quick shoutouts to those that have supported me on Patreon. The Icopod Wrestling Podcast, where Bob Collings Jr. and Austin Skinner discuss all things early 90s and Attitude Era WWF. So if you are a fan of the old school pro wrestling, go and check them out on iTunes and Podbean. To N64 ROM hacker Fianarx, who has created some of the GoldenEye 007 custom mods that I have played on this channel. He does occasionally post previews of these mods as well as other projects that he is working on his own YouTube channel, so go and check him out, like his videos, and subscribe. And to fellow YouTube retro gamer Junkman, who specializes in Let's Plays of retro N64 games. So if you want a different perspective on the N64 classics, go and check him out on his YouTube channel, like his videos, and subscribe to him as well. Links to all of these patrons are in the description down below. On to Kiro Sewers. This is the entrance. Grandpa says to watch out for Beelome, whoever that is. It's probably a little dark down there, so keep alert. Alright. Gonna skip the save box, because we should not need it. And see what all is going on down here. Hey, look at that. We've got sewer rats. How appropriate. Grind out the jump a little bit. 136, not bad. And will a thunderbolt kill these guys? Not quite. Oh. Did not get my timing right on that. And Mallow has been silenced. Outstanding. Taken care of. Alright. What, by the way, do my stats look like? 68 and 22. Forget it. Let's just move forward. Or, you know, end up in another battle, which is totally not my intention. Alright, now let's try moving forward. There we go. Actually, before I do that, I need... Crap, come on, run away! Ah, that's bad. Oh, perfect. Oh my god. You know, I'd like to get through the sewers in a reasonable amount of time here. Holy shit, there we go, okay. Come on, come on. Fuck. I might be able to salvage that. Use the invincibility frames to take a shortcut. Heal, and we will save here. And actually, we need to do one of those one more time. Come on, come on, come on. There we go, that is exactly what I wanted. That will be a key item later in the game. What the fuck? Alright, whatever. Though that box will be a key item later in the game, but I guess the developers figured... Oh, yeah, you can get up there without actually doing the thing you're supposed to do. So... what the hell is this four-eyed thing? Of course, I have no right to talk. This must be Beelome. Is that a fire hose or his tongue? Mo-ho-ho. Ack, it's a snack attack and you're it. But fortunately, we can do some pretty heavy damage to him. Ooh, room service has been kind to me. Where's my bib? Perfect, blocked it. Excellent. I actually forget offhand how much health Beelome has. I think it's like 700 something. Stick for a body, head full of straw. Give me a scarecrow, rah, rah, rah. What the hell kind of high school did you go to? That does not hurt me in the slightest. I can still use my special attacks. 147, excellent. Can't stand it. The hunger, the hunger. Not gonna make the joke. And that's goodbye, Beelome. If you defeat me, you still won't beat me. Beware the flood. No boss can stand up to Mario and his mighty jump. Beelome must have been lying when he said that water would come gushing out of here. Mario, do you hear something? Or is it just me? I hear a really, really bad 90s sound effect. Water! Here it comes! Mario, hit the button before we're washed away! Oh, Mallow, you useless puffball. And it's minigame time! This is the Midas River course. Want a crash course on it? Nah, I know how to do it. So now you get to enjoy a few minutes of just watching me collect coins. It's basically like watching me play the original Super Mario Brothers. I need to get at least 60 coins and a few frog coins that are floating around here. Which side has got... this side, okay. Those frog coins are absolutely critical to a future point in the game. Come on, get this coin and then I have to get back over to the other side. There we go. Come on, get over there. Get over there, excellent. And now, if only I could remember the pattern on the barrel jumping event. Need some pointers? Nah. I think I can figure it out on my own. Just time everything right, and I'm good. Enjoy the music for a moment. Ah, shit, I should have switched sides. Oh well. And switch sides. Nope. Okay, excellent. No. Yeah, fuck. Come on, Lance, get it together. You know what? I'm just gonna stick to this side. Cannot get hit by the fish. If I do, I'll lose coins. Now switch sides. Nope. Fuck. The double coin is throwing me off. Come on, B60. B60. I did not keep count, so B60. 73, excellent. Trade the coins you got from Midas River for frog coins. As a first-time only bonus, I'll give you one frog coin for 60 of your coins. Blah, 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 green coins or frog coins, blah, blah, blah. And a new equipable, beautiful. Do I need the wake-up pin now? Hang on, I've gotta think. Yes. Put that on Mario. For a future boss fight, spoiler alert. And on to Tadpole Pond. Lot of exposition in this episode. Hi, can I help you? Mallow, it's you. We've heard all about your adventures with Super Mario. You guys beat up Beelom, right? You know about that? See, Mario, the waterways of the world bring news to us here. That's why Grandpa knows all the news that's fit to hear. Are you really THE Super Mario? Hey everybody, you'll never guess who's here! He's the real thing, but he doesn't look anything like I thought he would. They do say he can jump better than a froggy. I wonder if it's only a rumor. So, once again, I have to show off my super jump, because apparently, being the gossip center of the world, nobody here knows what Mario dresses like. Despite the fact that nobody else in the Mario universe dresses in a red shirt and blue overalls. Video game logic, right? Well, Grasshopper, what's new? Grandpa, Mario's been helping me. I know, child. That rainstorm we just had. That was you, wasn't it? Ouch! Watch it up there! You're supposed to make me look like I'm floating here, okay? Welcome. So you are Mario, yes? I am Frog Fuchsius. You have come to seek wisdom from me, have you not? I've been waiting for you. Yes, old wise people can often give good advice. But how rude of me. Let's get more comfortable. Come along and we'll talk. Clear, full reverse. Tadpoles, don't just float there, make yourselves useful. Form a bridge for Mario. You know, Frog Fuchsius, that was just subtle. Yes, come into my sanctuary and partake of my wisdom, children. Let's see. That smithy character that appeared at Bowser's Keep. He is quite formidable, yes? And Mario, you wish to rescue the princess quickly, do you not? But oh, if only you knew the truth. Toadstool is no longer there. Patience, young one. Let me explain. Here is what happened. You were rescuing Toadstool from Bowser's Keep. After defeating him, and just when you were about to free the princess, you heard a loud crash and saw a huge sword split the sky. Whoosh! Out of the blue. The shock sent the three of you flying. Bowser and Toadstool are still lost somewhere out there. Now, you're worried about the princess, but first you need to take care of Smithy. His underlings are wreaking havoc in our world. Mac, whom you defeated at Mushroom Kingdom, was one of them. More will be coming. Grandpa, I almost forgot to tell you something. We found a star in the castle at Mushroom Kingdom. Do you know why it was there? A star, eh? Most interesting. This may sound illogical, but I believe shooting stars can grant wishes. And now, more than ever, I believe they will play a vital role in the fight against Smithy. Was that too much to absorb? Would you like a recap? No, I'm trying to get this episode done in a reasonable amount of time, so please shut up. It's quite a situation we have in our hands, isn't it? Wow, everything sounds so dire and serious. I guess Mac was only the first of many, Mario. Some of them will make Bowser seem nice. Hint, hint. Mallow, you speak as if these things do not concern you. You will accompany Mario on his adventure, too. Grandpa, what are you talking about? I'm only a simple tadpole. This adventure isn't for me. Mallow, my boy, I've kept this from you until now, but you're not a tadpole.
Say what?
Am I the only one who isn't surprised by this revelation whatsoever? I was sitting here one rainy day enjoying a snack of crickets, when I happened to see a basket floating down from the falls. I peeked inside and saw a little baby staring right back at me. The name Mallow was written on his belt. I felt sorry. I felt sorry for the little bundle of puff and took him in to raise as my own grandchild. He had powerful magic, and I knew he was more than a piece of fluff. I thought, surely this child must be from some far-off land. Grandpa, you mean I'm not a tadpole? Mallow, now is not the time to cry. Go with Mario, I can't talk today. Go with Mario on his adventure and find your real family. Your real mother and father are out there somewhere. Psst, Mario. This boy's magic is sure to come in handy on your adventure. You'll take him along, yes? Grandpa, I won't cry anymore and I'll go on this adventure with Mario and find my real family. Then it is settled. You must embark on your adventure immediately. First, go to Rosetown where they need your help. It will be quiet around here with Mallow gone. Maybe a snack will cheer me up. That's right, I had forgotten all about it. I will give you something for the cricket pie you brought back. Ah, I know. You shall have the staff I used when I was Mallow's age. There, the froggy stick will come in handy. Do not forget to equip it. Let's see, froggy stick to Mallow, and we are off. What the hell, may as well get through the rest of this episode's exposition. Off to Rose Way. And across the blocks we go. Collecting some items along the way. And can I get the trick? Nope. Ah, there is a way you can get up there without defeating the Shy Guys, but not quite good enough at it. And the star slaps a rather suggestive little dance there. And a level up. Mallow learns Psychopath. And a health boost. Something tells me to get rid of this thing in the middle. Yeah, fat load of good the attack up did. And thank goodness for that wake up pin. Just have Mallow defend here. Hey, got the perfect block, nice. For those of you watching that have not played this game, every physical attack in the game has a really small frame window where you can actually, did I say physical attack? Yeah, every physical attack has a frame window where you can actually block the attack and do zero damage. trying to focus on this thing. I can't actually think right now. All that for a frog coin, but like I said, I do, in fact, need them. Come on, come on, come on. Let's get through Roseway. Gonna skip the battles in this one. The jump is gonna do enough damage. There we go. What's going on up here? Well, would you look at that? It's our old pal Bowser. Alright, people, form ranks. Attention, shelled warriors. Hooded sorcerers. And last but not least, groundling Goombas. This is our finest moment. The Koopa Troop is invincible. We shall be victorious. The bridge is down, but we'll find a way to get back in. Move out, on the double. Bowser and his troops must be on their way to Bowser's Keep. Yeah, no shit, Sherlock. Come on, Rosetown is just up ahead. And this is where we will leave off, because there is, well, spoiler alert, there is going to be some shit going down in Rosetown. I did not intend to rhyme that. But if you enjoyed the video, be sure to like, comment, and or subscribe. Hit the links in the description box. Yeah, the description box. Follow me on Facebook and Twitter, and do please support this channel on Patreon. If you do not wish to throw a couple of bucks my way, then please share these videos on Reddit, on your own social media pages, with your mom, your dad, your sister, your brother, your cat, your dog. Just get the word about Entropic Decay Gaming out there. And we will see what Rosetown has in store for us next time. Until then, this is Lance Cassidy, signing off.